appears that it's lucky for me that everything is running out while we're here in town. I just tried to turn the water heater on and it said no. So that probably means I'm out of gas, and that's something I've never had to replace yet since I bought the RV. So this is gonna be a new experience. I've already taken the rivets off of my setup here. You'll see what I'm talking about. It was kind of silly how they set this up, and it made it very difficult to get to the tanks. So I'm trying to make it easier. So this will be my first run on if this is easy to do or if I need to adjust something, and which is great because we're here in town. So here we go. Okay, so here's my setup for the tanks here on the front of the RV. They had these pop rivets in this plastic container that I took a drill and I drilled out, because to get this top piece off, I had to remove this whole piece and take the generator off, which, what a pain, right? So I decided that I was going to kind of destroy this thing, but then added these pieces here, which I actually found when I was doing it, but it worked out perfect. So it's a thumb screw basically, and I'm gonna go buy a couple more, especially now that I'm going to replace these. But this will be the first time I'm removing them completely to try to take the tanks out. So we'll see. So when I was here trying to turn on the water heater this morning, I ended up with a little light on my control panel that was, I had to Google because I hadn't seen it yet. And when I noticed the other day, I didn't seem to have a whole lot of hot water, I wondered if I was getting low on gas. Well, it just so happens, I Googled the fault light, and it's the pilot light isn't lighting, which generally means you're out of gas. So I'm gonna show you here what I'm talking about, but that it leads me to the next part of investigating how to remove the tanks, so exchange them for something full. Okay, so here's my panel, and when I turn on the water heater here, it lights up. And well, this has never lit before. So I had to Google what that meant, and that means, guess what, lady? No hot shower for you. So that's okay. We're just gonna get new tanks. Okay, so this is my setup after I have removed the clamshell that goes around them. I'm gonna go ahead and shut these off here. I believe since they both go through this one regulator that they both need to be replaced. So, which is great because then I know I have full tanks leaving. I'll look, there's instructions here. Do not. We'll have to take a peek at those. But we've got them both turned off now. Oops. Closed all the way up so that we can remove these tanks. Investigating a little bit, we figured out that we still had one tank that was good. This handy dandy regulator here turns red when it's empty and then turns green when you point it to the next one. See this little arrow part here is pointing to my other tank, which means it's now going to be drawing out of there. Fabulous. I love easy and straightforward. So that means I still have hot water, which is kind of nice. And that means that I know for sure that this one is empty and I can remove it and replace it before we leave town. I probably will just get an extra tank to put in the truck too, in case the other one goes bad. But you know, that's for in the future. I did find some instructions here attached to my tank, which was really nice. It helped tell me about the regulator and how to do that. And when I'm ready to remove them, I just remove this nut here, the bracket comes off, undo the hoses, and ta-da! So that was way less scary. This is, we're doing well.